How do you add closed captions to your videos? That's what we're going to be talking about in this video. Hey, this is Leslie Samuel here from becomeablogger.com, where we're changing the world one blog at a time. Let's talk about closed captions. First of all, what are they? You know, here's an example. I'm looking at this video that I just uploaded today, and you can see not only can you watch the video, but you can see the kind of like the transcript of the video right at the bottom of the video. Now, this comes in very handy for a number of reasons. One of the reasons is the fact that some of the people that are watching your stuff may be international and maybe they don't get your accent or whatever the case might be. Sometimes you speak a little fast and that's hard to follow. At least that's for me, maybe not you. It's nice to have that text there that they can read as a closed caption. But in addition to that, on Facebook, when someone first sees your video, oftentimes there's no audio that goes along with it. They have to actually turn on the audio in order to get it. Well, having those closed captions there can be a good way of giving them an idea of what it's about and enticing them to click through to actually watch the video. It's just a win-win situation for everyone involved. But the question is, how do you do it? Now, there are a number of ways to do it. You can do it manually, or you can have someone do it for you. And I'm going to show you what I've done and how I do it, the different ways that I've done it. So I want to show you really quick how you go about adding a closed caption to a video. So I'm going to come out of this video right now, and I'm going to look for a video that doesn't have closed caption on it. And I know this video with my son doesn't, so I'm going to click on edit. And before I actually move on, if it's a video like this video here, you will notice I don't have the ability to edit that video. That's because I was just tagged in this video. I did not upload this video. So I'm going to go to this one that I uploaded and click on edit this video. And when I do that, I have a number of different options. The one that I'm looking for is to upload an SRT file. That is a specific file type that is for closed captions. Now, what you'll notice here is that it tells you, it gives you some instructions for the format of this file. It needs to be the file name .en, if it's English, underscore US in caps, if it's US English, .srt. So when you are naming the file that you are uploading, it has to be in this format. The first time I uploaded a file, it just had the file name and it told me there was an error and I couldn't figure it out until I read and saw that it had to be named this particular way. So if I wanted to upload a file, I would choose the file here, and here we see this one is called hangingfinal.en_us.srt, and I would upload that file. I'm not going to do that right now because that's not the actual file that goes along with this video, but I wanted to show you that really quick. Now, let me show it to you on YouTube. I'm going to come over here to YouTube, and I am looking at a video here that I'm editing. So once you go into the video manager, you go to edit that video, and you will see there's a subtitles/closed captioned field. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And you can see I can add new subtitles. I'm going to click on that and select English, or you can search for one of the other languages. And you will notice here, I'm going to pause that you have a number of options. You can upload a file, you can transcribe it yourself and auto-sync it. You can create new subtitles, you could buy subtitles and have basically someone do it. It's a little more expensive this route than the ways that I'm going to show you. But the one that I'm looking for is upload a file. I'm going to click on upload that file. It's a subtitle file, and then I can go ahead and choose the file and choose that SRT. Now, it doesn't matter how you name this file for YouTube. It matters for Facebook. That is why I recommend you get it named for Facebook, and that is the SRT file that you're going to use, whether you're using it on Facebook, YouTube, or some other platform. Okay, so I'm going to cancel this out right now and talk about how I get my stuff transcribed. There are two ways, and I've tried them both. I'm going to start with the most affordable one, which is Trint.com. Trint.com is really cool because It basically uses software to transcribe your stuff for you, but it's extremely accurate. It's the most accurate one that I've found. I've tried the Facebook auto transcription and YouTube auto transcription, and they just don't get my voice, my accent, or something, because it makes it look like I'm saying some really ridiculous stuff. Trint does a good job. But let me show you something about Trint. Here's a transcript that it did for me. Once you upload a video, it takes a minute or two, and then it gives you the transcript, depending on the length of the video. Mine are relatively short videos, so it happens relatively quickly. Then you will see that it will have the transcript here, and I can play.
I was born and raised on the beautiful Caribbean.
And as I'm talking, it is going through the transcript so I can see exactly where it is. If I want to jump to a point because I see, hey, there's an error here, I can just quickly click here and play it.
In a classroom or in a lab.
And it will play from that point, and I can say, you know what, it's not a lab, it's a laboratory, or whatever the case might be. So you can edit it right here. As you're kind of going through, and it makes it relatively easy, and you can export that file, the entire document, as a subrip format, that's the SRT, or you can do it as a Word document, another a VTT format, or an interactive transcript. I don't use any of those, but I would go with a subrip format for the purpose of what we're doing right now. One other thing to mention, here the price is $12 an hour. So if I am uploading a 5-minute video, that's going to cost me about $1 to get the transcript for that specific video. I think that's pretty affordable. If I'm doing a 5-minute video every day for 30 days, that's just $30 for 30 transcripts. I think that's pretty cool. Okay, so that is option number one. Option number two is Rev.com. Now, I prefer Rev.com, and I've started using this exclusively. It's a little more expensive. It's $1 a minute, so a $5 video is going to cost me $5, but they are very accurate. I don't even look over the transcripts anymore once they're done by Rev.com, because I know that it's pretty close to accurate, if not 100% accurate. Sometimes I've seen a little error here and there, but they do a pretty good job because they actually have human beings that are doing it for you. The machines haven't taken over yet, not completely, but they will. When I sign in here to Rev.com, I'm going to go ahead and log in. Once I've logged in, I can place a new order. I can say I want some subtitles or captions. You can call them whatever you want. It's just you will tell them in the end what format you want. So here you can see you can upload the files from your computer. You can share a link to a public video, or you can get it directly from your YouTube or Vimeo account and have them do that entire process for you, transcribe it, and then add it to the video. I generally upload my files so that I can get the SRT file downloaded, and when I'm ready to post the video, then I post it and upload that SRT file. So that's pretty much it. That's how I do it. That's how I get my closed captions added to my video. It's a relatively straightforward process. If you're making one video a week and that video is 5 minutes long or even 10 minutes long, you're spending about $5 to $10 a week to get these done by actual human beings. You really can't beat that. Or if you want to go more affordable, go with Trint.com and you're paying significantly less. So that's it. This is the end of the video. I hope you got some value from that. If you know somebody else that you think could find value in it, share it with them. Make sure to like the video or react to the video in some way. Leave a comment and let me know what you thought. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. Of course, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, like the Facebook page if you're on Facebook, and add me to your See First list. This is Leslie Samuel here from becomeablogger.com, where we're changing the world one blog at a time. And until next time, take care and God bless.